While I have not yet shared a reaction video, like to a music video or a song on this channel, it is something that I love doing. I'm very passionate about it, specifically with my favorite artist. And the reason I'm choosing to share this reaction today, which I'm going to be reacting to the new NF song that just dropped, the first song that he's put out like this since 2021. March 2021 is the last time that Clouds mixtape came out. And the reason I wanted to react to this on camera, I almost just listened to the song and I'm like, nope. I let the first like 2 or 3 seconds play and I'm like, no, hold on a second. I want to react to this because the title of the song, Hope, is so much the theme of what I'm trying to get to with my recovery. I feel very hopeless most, if not all, of the time. 2022, I was very devoid of hope all year until a few moments toward the end of the year, the last 2 or 3 months of the year. But if I'm being completely honest, hope is still kind of a hard commodity to come by. So I wanted to react to this video today because if you're not familiar with NF, he's a rapper. He is from Gladwin, Michigan. His first full album that came out was in 2015. It was called Mansion. And I've been a fan since his NF EP came out in 2014. And every album, every single, every mixtape since, I've just fallen in love with it. And since I've been a fan and followed his music and his career and his life for so long, I have been able to observe as he has learned so many things over the years. And he puts all of that into his music in a way that is just so raw and real and relatable. There's a reason that his handle is NF Real Music, because it's all about keeping things real, and that's what he does. And one reason so much of this is stuff that I can relate to is not just with mental illness in general, but he also struggles with OCD. Now, he was not diagnosed until he was an adult, just a handful of years ago, I believe, if I'm thinking of the song lyrics and the dates that this certain song came out. Leave Me Alone is a song, by the way. Go check it out. It's really powerful. But obviously, as someone who has OCD and as someone who currently is dealing with quite a bit of hopelessness when it comes to eating disorder recovery, which is affected by OCD as well, I've always been able to relate to the music. And I love the fact that this track is titled Hope, and I have a feeling it's going to be super, super powerful. So my heart's racing because I'm so excited. Like, I saw the notification the song was coming out, and I texted it to Roger yesterday, and I'm recording this on my phone because I wasn't planning to do a reaction. My camera batteries are dead. My SD card is missing, and I don't want to have to wait to record it for all those things to be charged. So phone it is, getting into this reaction. NF, Hope, let's go. Deep breath to regulate the nervous system first.
Hope. Yeah, I'm on my way. I'm coming. Don't lose faith in me.
Okay, this first clip, I'm not going to pause it this often, but this first clip is the clip that he shared on Instagram yesterday. And this was basically, it says, you know, hope, I'm on my way, I'm coming. From just that clip yesterday, can you understand why I'm so excited for this song? I would like hope to come here. I would like to not lose my way in trying to find hope. All right, let's go.
I know you've been waiting. I know you've been praying for my soul. Oh, oh. Years you've been dragging your feet, telling me I'm the reason we're stagnant.
Okay, so just my very first impression. He always has so many layers to the imagery in his music videos and in his lyrics and his songs in general. He actually has a song called Layers on the Clouds mixtape that talks sort of about that a little bit. I'm not going to try to dissect all the imagery in this because I just want to enjoy the song and all that, but it seems like from the very beginning words here, he's talking about a relationship. I think he's 30 years old, so that relationship would most likely be one of his parents. His mom, obviously, he lost his mom at a very young age and then doesn't have a great relationship with his dad. I know that he's spoken about that on other songs, and I'm wondering if that's who this song's about. Let's see. Actually, you know what? Here's my prediction. The person that he's talking to about 30 years is actually a personification of the word hope. So my guesses are he's trying to get a relationship with hope for the first time in his life. Let's see what happens.
30 years you've been claiming your honest and promising progress. Well, where's it at? I don't want you to feel like a failure. I know this hurts, but I gave you your chance to deliver. Now it's my turn.
Okay, again, don't know exactly what angle this is going to come from, but that passage right here really spoke to me as far as my eating disorder recovery goes, because he said, you know, 30 years, it gave you a chance to deliver. He never did. I'm paraphrasing. But I've been dealing with this eating disorder for 20 years, and I've given it 20 years to actually deliver on all the things that it's promised me, and it still hasn't really delivered on those things, not in the way that it said it would.
Get me wrong. But it's time to give the people something different.
What's this gonna be? He said something different. What the heck's this gonna be? Oh, hold on, the song's Hope. He's always done this serious, super moody music. He's even gotten criticized for that. You can see the sun starting to come through the clouds here. I bet the hope is gonna be something different. I love the vibe of this song already. It's more upbeat. It's like, already maybe feeling a little bit of hope. We'll see.
So without further ado, I'd like to introduce my album. Hope. What's my definition of success?
Okay, so there's a line in the song there. What's your definition of success? The song Why that starts out, what's your definition of success? I don't trust these thoughts to go inside my head. I don't trust this thing that beats inside my chest. Who I am and who I want to be cannot connect. Why? Yeah, it's in why. There's a callback there. And all that my album, back and forth, all the noise. I have a feeling there are going to be a lot of Easter eggs in here.
Listening to what your heart says. Standing up.
Wait, hold on. I want to point out, he is in all white. He always wears black or dark gray, period, in these videos. Always black or dark gray, never white. He's wearing white from head to toe. He's wearing white. If that's not a symbolism from the darkness of all of the difficult stuff and the depression and the OCD and the hopelessness to moving into hope and light, what? That has to be the imagery there. I love it. I'm crying because I love it so much. I guess it's an emotional day for me.
What you know is what will everybody else is tucking their toe between their legs. What's my definition of success? Creating something no one else can. Being brave enough to dream big. Grinding when you're told to just quit. Giving more when you got nothing left.
Giving more when you're told to just quit. Giving more when you have nothing left. Again, for me, kind of resonates on a recovery level, because your eating disorder always wants you to give more than you can really give and to continue giving it all of your attention when it's really stolen all that you don't have any of yourself. But okay.
Let them take a chance on something they were talking never happened. It's a person that can see the bright side through the dark times when there ain't one. It's from someone who ain't never had nothing.
What did I tell you? He does this so much, talking back between NF and whatever the voice in his head he's signifying. Sometimes it's NF versus fear that he's personified as the voice in his head. Sometimes it's NF versus doubt. Sometimes, you know, there are all these different things that he does there. You can see the all black version, all dressed in black version of him is up on this rock here on the beach. The all dressed in white version is down there. They're going back and forth already, talking about that very dichotomy of hopelessness to hope and light and dark. And oh my gosh, I'm getting chills.
Afraid to walk away from more perfect, because they'd rather do something that they really love and take the pay cut. It's a person that would never waver or change who they are, just to try and gain some credibility so they can feel accepted by a stranger. It's a person that can take the fears in their life and turn them into motivation. It's believing in yourself when no one else does. It's amazing.
Being able to take the failures in life and turn them into motivation. It's believing in yourself when no one else does. It's amazing. I just want that concept to hang there for a second. Believing in yourself when no one else does, that's a pretty amazing thing.
What a little bit of faith can do if you don't even believe in you. Why would?
Okay, so you're saying it's amazing what a little bit of faith can do if you don't even believe in you. Okay, we're going to rewind that a little bit. Sorry, I got ahead of myself.
It's believing in yourself when no one else does. It's amazing what a little bit of faith can do if you don't even believe in you. Why would you think or expect anybody else that's around you to? I done did things that I regret. I done said things I can't take back. Was a lost soul at a crossroad who had no hope, but I changed that.
Oh my gosh. Don't have the lines memorized. I'm not going to scroll back through it continuously, but like, it's amazing what a little bit of faith can do when you don't believe in yourself I'm just like, this song is just hitting home hard. I spent years of my life holding on to- Oh, wait, and I was going to point out, he was talking about not being able to believe in himself. And then at the end of that section, he was giving himself credit for not giving up and continually searching and eventually finding the hope that he now has. One of the things I never should have kept, full of hatred. Years of my life carrying a lot of baggage that I should have walked away from. Years of my life wishing I was someone different, looking for some validation. Years of my life trying to fill a void, pretending I was in. They get it. This room looks eerily similar to the room that the Why music video was filmed in. Not exact, but there are a lot of similarities. Of course, there are a lot of music videos that have some similar aesthetics. 2 minutes left. What the heck can still come in 2 minutes? This has been awesome. Chills! Okay, so all that, my album. He 100% is pulling from all of his albums because this line right here is from Mansion, from the title track, Mansion. This insidious is blind inception. Oh, I'm geeking out over this, guys. My gosh. Evil, difficult to go through, yes, but beneficial. Okay, I was not. I knew something was going to happen there. You could tell that there was going to be a big drop, but the way it just went completely black and popped on screen, I was not expecting that. But this is about to go off, so I am going to rewind it so I'm not talking through that transition like an idiot. But the transition from those really melodic lines in Mansion to what you can tell is getting ready to go really hard. And he's walking through this mansion, which he has used in all of his albums as imagery for his brain and his life and everything that he's kept locked inside and all of that. And I'm really excited to see what he's going to do to the house. I have a feeling he's going to start turning some lights on because they've always been filmed in really dark locations. Could be wrong. Let's see, though. Rewound it just a little bit again so we can get that transition so I don't, you know, ruin it by talking. Necessary evil, difficult to go through, yes, but beneficial. Some would say having a mental breakdown is a negative thing, which on one hand I agree, but on the other hand, it was the push I needed to get help and start the healing process. See, if I'd never hit my bottom, would I be the person that I am today? I don't believe so. Just pointing out, you don't necessarily have to hit rock bottom of rock bottom of rock bottom to have this realization, to have this come to Jesus moment, to become the person you are, to finally make a change. But he's acknowledging that that's what it took for him to finally get the courage to reach out, to go to therapy, to seek help for what he now knows was undiagnosed OCD. And I just love that he's speaking out on that. I'm a prime example of what happens when you choose to not accept defeat and face your demons. Took me 30 years to realize that if you want to get the opportunity to be the greatest version of yourself, sometimes you gotta be someone you're not to hear the voice of reason. Having kids will make you really take a step back and look in the mirror. At least for me, that's what it did. Okay, well, something about to go down here as that hood is getting pulled over his head, but my guess here, I'm pretty sure that the older man we just saw in that cage is the same man that was in a video that was signifying an older Nate, like several years ago. Yeah, so let's see what's happening here. Wake up every day and pick my son up, hold him in my arms and let him know he's loved. Love. Standing by the window questioning if that is ever going to show up. Isn't something he's gonna have to worry about. And in his song, several songs about his mom, specifically How Could You Leave Us, he talks about sitting by the window every day waiting for her to come back. All of these callbacks, I'm so glad that he's found hope and that it very obviously has come as a result of his son being born and being a father. Don't get it twisted, that was in a shot. Mama, I forgive you, I just don't want him to grow thinking that he'll never be enough. 30 years of running, 30 years of searching, 30 years of hurting, 30 years of pain, 30 years of fearful, 30 years of anger, 30 years of empty, 30 years of shame. What? What? 30 years of broken, 30 years of anguish, 30 years of hopeless, 30 years of hey, 30 years of never, 30 years of maybe, 30 years of later, 30 years of faith, 30 years of hollow, 30 years of sorrow, 30 years of darkness, 30 years of day, 30 years of baggage, 30 years of sadness, 30 years of stagnant, 30 years of change, 30 years of patience, 30 years of suffering, 30 years of torment, 30 years of... Oh my goodness. So I pause it there. You can see he's getting like the black Joker paint is from space again. There's some black coming on the collar of his shirt. It's like the darkness is trying to come back in as he's recounting all of these things he's dealt with for his entire life. Shame, anger, bitterness, hopelessness, all of this. You can see that the darkness is trying to take back over the light. And I'm just, oh my gosh. And he just, this list of stuff, it seems so simple, but it's so, it just hits so hard.
30 years of bitter, 30 years of lonely, 30 years of pushing everyone away. You'll never evolve. I know I can change. We are not enough. We are not the same.
Oh my gosh. I'm not making this about me, but I just love the way that he puts his imagery on there, because there is no way that I'm not also hearing this conversation between my eating disorder voice and my healthy self voice, because the eating disorder voice tries to take me over with the darkness and the healthy self voice is desperately trying to find the hope and light.
You don't have the heart, you don't have the strength, you don't have the will, you don't have the faith, you'll never be loved, you'll never be safe, might as well give up, not running away, you don't have the guts, you're the one afraid, I'm the one in charge, I'm taking the, reins.
I'm taking the reins. At the end, they were arguing back and forth, him and whatever he is using as this, whether it's the hopelessness, the depression, the fear, whatever he is using this personification of today, the white clothing, all of that, that white imagery being hope, the dark imagery being a representation of all of the past darkness. And then at the end there, all of the black was gone away again. He's in all white. After there was the back and forth of, I'm in charge, no, you're in charge, no, you're in charge. He said, I'm taking the reins. I'm taking control. Hope is taking the reins. Hope is driving the ship. Hope is now propelling our life forward. After I mentioned that thing about his mom, the very next lines were an apology to his mom, saying that it wasn't like hating on her, but he was making sure his son would never have to deal with what he had to deal with, never knowing if his mom was going to come back, ultimately losing her. Wow. I'm taking the reins. Hope. Because that's what he was there. That's what him dressed in all white was a personification of, hope. The black, again, darkness, depression, whatever he is signifying specifically with that, it varies sometimes, but it usually has to do with just the general darkness, hopelessness, depression, struggles, stuff like that. Wow. Wow. Not only was that a perfect testament to how much his life has improved, how much hope he now has, but like I said throughout, it was just such a perfect allegory to me. So many of the lines are literally things that are very similar to things that I've written down when I'm doing dialogues between the eating disorder voice and the healthy self voice. And I can guarantee you this song is going to be on my top 5 Spotify Wrapped songs of 2023. I'm going to go listen to it again now so I can start memorizing it, because holy moly, that was amazing. I don't have anything else to say.